your church, build your church, build it from the ground up. It's your church, build your church, build your church, build it from the ground up. We're your church, build your church, build your church, build it from the ground up. It's your church, build your church, build your church.
And as we are united tonight to lift up the name of Jesus,
yes,
and to tell him thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, we are grateful.
Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, O God.
Forever and ever.
We thank you for making this house
Jesus,
a place where we can call home.
You, Lord.
I don't know about for you, but this ministry has transformed my life.
Come on, come on.
Day after day, the teachings of Prophet Seth. Jesus. And we have made it to 10 years. And many ministries can't say that. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jehovah.
Jesus.
Father, I thank you.
Yes.
We thank you for what you're about to do on tonight. All glory to your name, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
I get emotional because when I look back and where I was 5-6 years ago, you wouldn't see me holding a mic.
Come on, testify.
I mean, I still run from holding a mic. But the shepherd over this house,
come on.
Oh, Jesus. I want us to lift up our voices and we're thanking the Lord for our dear prophet Seth.
Yes, yes, yes.
Through him, God has used transformation to transform lives.
Yes,
all
Lord.
Caps, all capital letters.
Yes, yes. Come on.
He has made this ministry a safe place where you can be yourself, but at the same time, he pulls the woman of God or the man of God out of you.
Yeah.
And so many of us are doing things that we never thought in 100 years that we would do. You can't tell him no. Who knows knows?
No way.
He don't accept no's. Don't accept excuses. And so because what he pulls out of you, it begins to manifest and comes out so natural. You didn't even know all the giftings, all the talents that was in, that was there. You didn't even know it was there.
Come on.
But because he sees,
yeah.
He sees far ahead. He sees what you're called to do and where you need to be. Oh, Jesus. So as we lift up our voices, I want us to just thank the Lord for his life.
Yes, Jesus, we thank you for his life, Lord. And thank the Lord for what he has done through him. The words he has spoken over your life, and they are coming to fruition. The prayers that he has prayed for you.
Yes, Lord.
Many of us didn't know we could pray for 12 hours, much less an hour. But because of his obedience and his yes, there are things that we have done that we never thought we could do.
Come on.
Oh, Jesus. So I want you to pray from your heart for the next few minutes and just thank the Lord. And I want you to call out his name in the realms of the spirit.
Yes, Lord.
And declare some things over his life.
Yes, Lord.
And it's because of his yes and his obedience and his desire to not give up. We are made it to 10 years with the help of God.
Yes, Lord.
La bosa tarabada bazendele bede bosa. Riba gaduna mazindi mekentini madusa tini magadosa. Father, oh God, tonight as we have started to celebrate the 10 years of your faithfulness, God, we lift up our men of God before you tonight.
And you will see that God,
and we say, may he lack nothing.
Lord, thank you for preserving him. Oh Lord, his yes has brought us
God, we have thanked you for his yes to you, God. God, as he continues to pour out, God, we thank you for his life. We thank you for the covenant, oh God, that you have made with him. We thank you for his heart to serve. We thank you for his heart for the people.
Oh
God, may you continue to fill him up.
Oh
God, may he continue to dig
him,
deeper
Jesus.
In
we
you,
him,
oh God. May his hand let nothing. Oh God, may his hand, oh God, continue to war. Oh Father, as we lift him up before you tonight,
let this year be the reason why he smiles.
May you multiply him.
Oh
God, we put his generation in your hand. May his legacy may
Jesus,
be established tonight in the mighty name
destiny,
of Jesus.
Rather
the most that ever, oh God, we thank you, oh my God, and Amosa, Rebede, Pantalabaya, and Teleba de Bosa, Toraba, Rakate, oh God, may the oil of his life, may it never run dry. God, may his anointing, may it increase. Abadeya, Ikanto, Rabadosa, God,
Pelemetura, Badosa, Tanto.
Jesus. May his light continue to shine.
In the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name
of
Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Can we all lift up our hands?
Yes, Lord.
And we are saying, Father, tonight.
Father, tonight.
Oh, God, may we not miss your move.
Oh, God, may we
every
not miss
song
your
that will be lifted up. May it lift up a sound unto the heavens. And may the heavens be open. Open this atmosphere tonight. Oh, God, may I never leave the same way. Oh, God, send word to speak to my situation. Oh God, whatever it is, oh God, may I not miss it. May we not miss it tonight as we celebrate your goodness. God, may it be acceptable. May it be acceptable. May it be acceptable in the mighty name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
God calls you friend, and even Abraham, before Jesus Christ even came, because of his faith, he called unto him righteousness, and he called him friend. Tonight, we're going to welcome God. We're going to praise God. We're going to thank God for calling us friend tonight. It is because he has called us friend that we made 10 years. Father, we thank you. We worship you. We praise you. You are great. You are mighty. You are worthy to be praised. You are our helper. You are our deliverer. Thank you for your faithfulness towards us, that we can be called your friend. Prepare your hearts tonight to give praise unto the Lord. Amen. You call us friend. Wonderful Father, you call us friend. Wonderful Master, you call us friend. I don't think you guys understand. A friend is someone that you can share secrets with. A friend is someone that will help you in your time of need. A friend is someone who will help lift you up when you can't anymore. A friend is someone who is there to encourage you. God has called us friends so much. He has given us his Holy Spirit that is here to help us, that is here to counsel us, that is here to lift us up, that is here to give us encouragement in our time of need. Come on, clap your hands today. Clap your hands. Who am I that you are mindful of me, that you hear me when I call? Is it true that you are thinking of me, how you love me?
Is it true that you are thinking of me? to hear me when I call. It's a privilege. Is it true that you are thinking of me? How you love me. It's amazing. 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 It's amazing.
Hallelujah.
Cry out hallelujah. We bless your name, Jesus. We are thankful that you are our dear friend. Isn't he a dear friend? Come on and lift up a shout of worship tonight. We have come to exalt his name. For I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus, we praise your name.
There is only one name.
Your name alone, we call you Jesus.
There is only one name.
confess that Jesus Christ, you are Lord. Hallelujah. Every knee must bow down before your glory, Jesus. And every tongue must confess, Lord, that Jesus Christ. You alone, you alone.
precious Holy Spirit, will you come down tonight just for a couple of moments, just for a few seconds, Lord, if you just come. Father, can you come tonight and restore our broken hearts? Precious Holy Spirit, will you come tonight? Will you come tonight? Have it all. And because God is the greatest power we shall ever, ever be defeated. And because God is the greatest power we shall ever, ever be defeated. Because God, we shall never,
we shall never,
ever be defeated,
ever be defeated.
And because God,
and because God,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Listen, this is 10 years in this land of Florida. I don't know why you are here, but this is 10 years of ministry in this land. Where others have failed, where others have given up, but God has been good. But when I was coming up here, I don't know if you know this song, but it says, we've come this far by grace, by faith. We've come this far by faith, leaning on the Lord, trusting in His only word. Never fail me yet. No, 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 no. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, we can't go back. We've come this far by faith. No, 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 no. Oh, no. Can someone, who knows the song? Come on. We come this far. I want you to dance. Show your appreciation unto God, because this is 10 years, 10 years. It hasn't been easy, it hasn't been easy, but we have come this far because He has given us the grace, because He has held our hand, just like He held the hand of Cyrus, and He brought us this far. Come on, somebody dance in appreciation to your God. Oh. Beginning might be small, but your latter shall greatly increase. I stand on this altar of Jehovah, and I declare into the life of VSC that your latter days shall greatly increase, that we are about to see the increase of God, that we are about to see the expansion of God. We are not going back, but we are going forward in glory. Mahaya Dabahaya. Jesus. Listen. Last Sunday, if you were here, Papa shared some stories of the beginning of the beginnings of this ministry. And I don't know about you, but when you listen to that story, it makes you appreciate where we are now. I know we are not where we want to be, but we are far from where we started from. Far from where we began. And I know God is about to do exceedingly, abundantly, far above what we can think, far above what we can even imagine. The Bible says eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, it has not even entered into the heart of man what I am about to do in the life of this church and in your life as well, because you are connected to this ministry. No one can even imagine what is about to happen. As Papa said, you know, when you are, for those of you who are archers with bow and arrow, if you want the arrow to go far, it's got to stretch. You can't just do this and leave it. It will just land right here. But because our steps are about to be magnified, and because we are about to take over, and because our presence is about to be known, God stretched us from the beginning, and he is about to release us to let us go. And so I want you to celebrate tonight, because you are about to step into something greater. Something new is about to happen. Something mighty is about to happen. Something glorious is about to happen. I don't know about you, but give the Lord a dance. Ayepahaya. Beatrice knows how to dance. I got these two ladies over here. David danced so much that in the end, he was naked before the Lord. I don't think we understand what the Lord has done for us. When COVID happened, a lot of churches were meeting here, but today they are no longer in ministry. It is not because our Papa is a good preacher. It is not because he is a great prophet. But it is by the grace of God. And if you understand this, I want you to dance and give God a praise. Give him a praise. Give him a praise. Give him a praise. Let your dance glorify the Lord. For 10 years in ministry, Ayeke Pahaya.
Glory to God. Listen, I want you to understand that this is the year of legacy. This is the month of legacy celebration. This is when we are about to make our mark. And so you are not here by accident. Something is about to shift in your life. Something is about to switch in your life. And men will see you and they will give glory to God. Hallelujah. God bless you, praise and worship team. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Glory to God. Please take your seat. Amen. And welcome again to the first night of our Legacy Conference. Amen. For those of you watching us live, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, make your way up here. Because there's so much power, there's so much fire, and you will truly be blessed. Amen. I'd like us to invite our sister Abina as she comes up.
Evening, Victory Faith Chapel. Welcome to day one of our Legacy Conference. This is our year of legacy and our month of divine surprises. Amen. Word of God, the healing and the prophetic ministry. Our mission is to train and develop Christ-like disciples that will have a transformational impact in their distinct spheres of influence. Our vision is to train, equip, empower, and to release the people of God for the work of the ministry and to make disciples of all nations, according to Ephesians 4, verses 12 to 16. We have three locations. Our main location is here in West Palm Beach. West Palm Beach, make some noise. At 3812 Jog Road, Lake Worth, Florida, 33467. Our second location is in Orlando. Orlando is in the house. At 9456 our Orange Blossom Trail, Orlando, Florida, 32837. West Palm Beach, we got to do better than Orlando. West Palm Beach here. All righty. Our third location is in Ghana, West Africa, located at Regent University, Accra, Ghana. It is now time to give reverence to our overseer, our said angel of this house. We ask that you all stand up. You stand up. You start jumping and shouting. As we give reverence to our papa, our doctor, our prophet, Seth Amwabwati. Come on, guys, you can do better than that. Let's keep going. 10 years in West Palm Beach. We are here today to celebrate the legacy of Victory Faith Chapel International. So we're going to do this one more time. I want you guys to run around and celebrate 10 years. Papa, our doctor, Seth Amwabwati. Come on, guys. Come on. All right. Thank you. Thank you so much. You may all be seated. At this time, we'd like to welcome our new visitors on social media, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram. You are welcome in the house today. If you're at home, it's not too late for you to join us here in West Palm Beach at our location here. If there are any new visitors in the house, please wave at us. Welcome. We're so happy to have you here. Victory Faith, what do we say? Thank you so much for visiting with us. We look forward to seeing you day two, day three, day four, and also at our legacy concert as well, West Palm Beach Legacy Concert. One of our ushers should have provided you with a visitor's card for you to fill out your information. We'd absolutely love to keep in touch with you and check on you from time to time to see how you're doing, and we hope to see you again. At this time, I would also like to invite Pastor Sean Allen from the Community Life Outreach to share a special message with us. Victory, let's welcome him.
All right, how's everybody doing tonight? Good. So my name is Sean Allen. I have the privilege of pastoring a church in the Palms, the church that built this building and from day one opened it up. We now have 12 different churches and ministries that call this place their home. Can somebody say amen to that? You come here on a Sunday morning, you'll hear people worshiping in English and Spanish and Creole, so many different churches and ministries. I want to just share really briefly what vision is behind all of that God is doing here in this place, and the vision behind Community Life, which is a network of churches and nonprofits and people who are partnering together on God's mission. So here's our vision. We believe, and I want to know if you believe, that every person that's a follower of Jesus Christ is all connected to God through Jesus Christ, all connected as one family. How many of you believe that tonight, right? That means that if you believe in Jesus and I believe in Jesus, we're brothers and sisters, amen? It doesn't matter whether you like me or not, we're brothers and sisters, amen? So if that's true, we believe that people ought to connect together and that we ought to be intentionally connecting together God's people. If God sees us as one, we ought to act like we're one. Can somebody say amen to that? And then lastly, we believe that we ought to join God's mission. God has been on a mission since the day he created this planet. He is still on a mission to bring people into the abundant life and eternal life through Jesus Christ. And so why would we all do that by ourselves, even our churches by ourselves? Why would we not partner together and live like we're all on the same mission? Amen? So on your seats, there's a card. It's for Community Life. If you want to become a part of what God is doing through Community Life, Victory Faith's already a part of it, but we'd love to invite everybody here tonight. Just simply text that number on the card or scan the QR code, and we'll keep you informed about how people are partnering together here in our local community on God's mission. And I want to invite you to one awesome event. It's Saturday night, April 1st, right here in this room. We are using jazz and blues and funk to tell the story of the last week of Jesus' life. And I want you to come out here. You got to buy a ticket, so we'll send you all the information if you text that number on the card or find someone at Victory Faith, and they'll connect you to tickets as well. But show up here Saturday night, April 1st, 7 p.m. The last time we did a big event like this, we had people from 17 different churches in this room all at the same time. We're telling the story of Jesus so that we will all partner together to share Jesus' story in our community. So on behalf of the Community Life Center, on behalf of Community Life, we celebrate what God is doing through Victory Faith. We celebrate what he's been doing, what he's doing tonight, and what he's going to do in the next 10 years through this ministry. Amen? So may God's blessings be on you. Thank you.
Amen, amen. Thank you so much. Our weekly schedule is as follows. We have our prayer line Monday to Tuesday from 9 to 10 p.m. The number to call is 561-223-8882. Our Supernatural School of the Word is on Thursdays from 7 to 9 p.m. in room 108. Friday is our prayer o'clock service from 8 to 11 p.m. And Sunday, our Victory service from 3 to 6 p.m. Our 10th year anniversary starts tonight. Actually, we started on Monday, but tonight is day one of our Legacy Conference. So we are absolutely 3 days away from our West Palm Beach Legacy Concert. How many of you have bought your tickets? This is going to be one of our major events. We'll be hosting our first Legacy Concert. We will have artists such as Grammy Award winner Chandler Moore of Maverick City, Dove Award winner Jacqueline Carr, international gospel artist Joe Metal, and this one here, Victory, gotta welcome UK Voice semi-finalist Emmanuel Smith. Come on, Victory, we can do better than that. Emmanuel Smith is in the house. And we have comedian Not Carlton Banks, Yashuka Savoy, and our own very own Teddy J. And Victory Worship. This event promises to be impactful, life-transforming, and empowering to everyone. For our conference, we will also have world-renowned guest speaker, Dr. Cindy Trim, in the house. And our spiritual father, Prophet Diallo Opon, as well. Listen, it's not too late to hand out flyers. We're 3 days away. There's still time for us to hand out flyers, make an impact, continue to put them on windshields. The ones you've put them on before, put them back there for them to see it a second time and a third time, right? For them to know that we have a concert coming up very soon. For those of you who haven't gotten your tickets, I encourage you to get them now. You can get your tickets at eventbrite.com, the West Palm Beach Legacy Concert, because you definitely don't want to miss this. If you're a small business owner, there is still opportunity to advertise your business at the conference. We still have some spots available. You can still email us at vfclegendconcert@gmail.com for more information. Volunteers, we are meeting Saturday morning at what time? 8 a.m. So we will be meeting Saturday at the concert event center at 8 a.m. Papa's Book Peculiarity is available to purchase in-house with our sister Josette in front here. Or if you want to purchase it on Amazon, it is available. You won't be disappointed when you read this book. This book is loaded with keys to you walking in your uniqueness. Destiny Counseling is still ongoing. You can register at victoryfaithchapel.org. This is a one-on-one session with our doctor and our prophet where he ministers to you, answers questions, and reveals keys to you concerning your destiny. If you're not aware, we are on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. Please search for Victory Faith Chapel, West Palm Beach. Like our page, set notifications so that when we go live, you can join us. Also, if you're interested in becoming a member, please see Sister Vanessa, who's in the house here in the back usually, and Sister Marsha as well, so they can give you a membership form. And if any of your information has changed as well, you can see them to update your information. At Victory Faith Chapel, we want to celebrate your birthdays, anniversaries, milestones that are important to you, and also celebrate with you and show love when you're going through difficult times. We are definitely a family, and we are so thankful that we're celebrating 10 years here. So at this time, I would like to invite back Sister Dee Dee, Deaconess Dee Dee.
Amen. Hallelujah. I expect the excitement in the house tonight to be like beyond the roof. I know most of us are getting off work and retired, but come on, blow it off the roof, okay? Amen. We have a video, and I'm gonna have the media team let me know if they're ready. We are gonna show a quick video as part of the 10-year anniversary. Playing for us, Redemptive Dance Group, if you can prepare yourself, because you will be going after this. I'm sorry, Prophetess Valencia, I apologize, if you can prepare yourself as you would be ministering. So let's give media team a few more minutes to get the video playing. Amen.
Join the happy 10th year anniversary VFC. Hey, this is Jimmy Cash from Victory Faith Chapel. I joined the ministry in 2014 at a church conference. I was playing somewhere and Pastor Seth, he had walked in and he had greeted everybody. And then I ended up seeing the flyer around that same time that he went to the church. He was having a conference in October. And then since then, I went to the conference and we was locked in. If we locked in, ain't no switching up. And by the grace of God, I'm still here. Prophet Seth, AKA my pops, you know what I'm talking about? When I first seen him, when he came to the church, I was like, wow, like I was everything about him, the way he prayed, the way he worshiped, and his passion. And I'm like, wow. Around that time, he was going from West Palm to Orlando. So I'm like, this gotta be real. Ain't nobody gonna be doing all that sacrifices and not really, you know. So since then, we just, yeah, just loved him. I remember a time he had told me that I was gonna begin to start prophesying, and it'll be deep things, it'll be very accurate. And since he gave me that word, it's been happening. It's been happening, like, every time, you know, the prophetic, or every time I prophesize, like, you know, God will honor his word. And like, I believe that he plays a big role in my life. So I thank God for it. It has really changed my life, because the route I was going before my mom passed, I was heading towards the street. But it's like God sent him, like, I always said this, God sent him for me personally, because it's like, he came around October and my mom died in February. So I feel like God sent the church for me. So me having this family, a church, that's what kept me from being, you know, with the wrong people, the wrong crowd, and just, you know, wasting my life. I believe VFC is a great ministry, and I believe it's not for everybody. But the ones who it's for, I believe that if they can take their time to really understand the vision and really put their all in the ministry, I believe that God would take it. One revelation that God gave me about VFC was that the church, everybody is a leader in VFC. Nobody is just a regular person. Everybody is a leader. The Lord showed me that that the man of God, Reverend Seth, is like God built them to begin to raise leaders that will be able to shake the world. So I believe that VFC is not just a normal ministry, but it is a ministry that was born to be at a set time we in right now. Jesus, he's the Son of God, and he's my friend. If you know me, you know me. I love face to face, everything face to face. So Jesus, like, in these last couple years, I've learned to get closer to him, and like I've seen him. You know, one thing about I learned about Jesus, there's many sides of him. Like, we all have many sides of us. But Jesus, he could be a friend, a brother, a father. It doesn't matter. Jesus, to me, he's been everything to me. Like, even since my mom died, like, you know, how it says that even when your mother, your father forsake you, I, the Lord, would take you in. I've testified and seen that through my personal connection with God. Through Jesus, the Son of God. Happy 10th year anniversary.
Hallelujah. Amen. We have a song ministration. Amen. By Prophetess Valencia, with a clap and a shout. Let us welcome her. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, Victory Faith. You can do better than that. Let us welcome the woman of God. Amen.
First, give honor to God, who is my keeper. Amen. Amen. I want to thank God for Pastor Seth for allowing me to be a part of this great venture that you are on. 10 years is a long time for ministry to be standing. That lets me know that you have a sure foundation.
Amen.
Amen. So, and that's true. Most ministries during the pandemic, Most of them shut down, and they stayed shut down. Amen. But I know I heard the Lord say that a lot of ministries weren't going to stand after, because he, truth be told, He never said for us to shut his house. So I don't want to, I'm not trying to prophesy, but he didn't say shut his house, because his house should always be a way of safety for us to run to. So I just thank God for the obedience of the leaders that kept the house open. Amen. And I'm not going to try to be before you long. Amen. Because I came to hear the word of God on tonight. Hallelujah. I am troubled, yet not distressed. Perplexed, but not in despair. I'm a vessel full of power with a treasure none can compare. Forsaken, cast down, but not destroyed. I'm a vessel full of Holy Ghost power. I've got a treasure from the Lord, bruised and battered, but not broken, born in sin, but from sin set free. Holy Ghost power, I have got a treasure in me. Thank you, Father, for your power. It has that my poor soul could not flee. Thank you, Father, for your power. It has resurrected me. Dances that my poor soul could not flee, 'cause I am a vessel full of power. I'm a vessel full of power. You are a vessel full of Holy Ghost power. I've got a treasure hidden in me. I love you, Jesus. I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything. How many of you believe that he loves you? Even when you mess up, even when you disobey. Oh, I love you, Jesus. I worship and adore you. I just want to tell you, hey, Lord, I love you more than anything. Yes, Lord, I worship and adore you. I just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything. Come on out. I dare you to give God a praise right there. If you love your God, say, I love you. I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
I just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
I love you. Decision.
is who I am. Oh, Lord, that's who I am. That's who I am. You're a good, good Father. That's who you are. Say, that's who you are. That's who you are. That's who you are.
And I'm loved.
And I'm loved by you.
It's who I am.
It's who I am.
It's who I am.
It's who I am.
Who I am.
It's who I am.
You're a good, good Father.
You're a good, good Father.
It's who you are.
It's who you are.
It's who you
are. It's who you are.
Who you are.
It's who you are.
And I'm loved. For your grace, you're a God, good Father.
It's
who you are.
It's who you are.
It's who you are. And I'm loved. I'm loved by you.
It's who I am.
It's who I am.
It's who I am.
You're a good, good.
You're a good.
That's who you are.
So perfect. You are to us. You are perfect.
Perfect in all of your ways.
You are perfect.
Lift it up again.
You're perfect in all.
Oh,
Lord,
you are perfect.
Perfect in all of your ways.
You are perfect.
Perfect in all of your ways.
To us. To us. Say you're a good.
Even found worthy to come into his presence. God bless you, prophetess. Amen. Hallelujah. We are moving on to the next most important item on the program. That is our offering. our offering, our sacrifice, our tithes. Amen. Come on. I want to see the same excitement. It is offering time. Offering time. Offering time. Hallelujah. The Bible says that believe in the prophet and believe in God who has the power to make you have wealth or to give you wealth. Offering, coming back to give to God, is a sign of your obedience to his word. That I understand that you gave to me, and it is good stewardship that I give back unto you. Tonight, I want you to encourage you tonight that God loves a cheerful giver. Tonight, we're going to dance. We're not just going to walk up to Sister Josette or Mama Doreen. We are actually going to dance in thanksgiving. Dance in praise. Dance in glory as we bring our offering unto the Lord. We have three forms of giving here. I think it's four now. We have Givelify, which you can access on our website, victoryfaithchapel.org. Just click on that button. You can also use Zelle and PayPal, and you can use the email address, victoryfaithchapel@gmail.com. And we do have the text to give as well, and I'll give you the number. Amen. You can just text. Amen. Let me pull that up. Hallelujah.
It's right there, right? I can't see that.
Oh, give VFC. Amen. Give VFC. Text that. Two, the number is 3-4, hold on. Thank you, amen. Oh my gosh. Text give VFC to 44321, amen. We are giving out of the abundance of our praise to God tonight. And so with everyone standing tonight, we're gonna do a little bit different, like I said. We are in celebration, and so we are going to show it in our giving. Hallelujah. You are going to dig deep down into those beautiful pocketbooks. And for the men, those bulky wallets, you're going to dig deep down, pull out all the cards, write out all the checks. And if you're writing a check, please make sure to write it out to Victory Faith Chapel International. Hallelujah. And we would invite praise and worship and Minister Teddy to give us a song. I want us to really understand this. Offering is a form of your worship. It is you worshiping God with your substance. And you know, prayer is easy, but when it comes to the real test, I heard a man of God say, the real test is when you are blessing God or you are worshiping God with your substance. And I know tonight we have some grateful, cheerful givers in this house who has come to just bring God the glory in their giving. So if we can stand as the praise and worship team gives us a song. Again, we are going to dance. You're not just coming and doing it as usual, but you are going to dance as they sing to bring your offering. Amen. Hallelujah. Nobody's dancing. I see you.
Running over.
Go ahead, Stephanie.
Press down. Yo, 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 yo. Running over. Running over. I'm expecting. I'm expecting.
Press down, shake it together, running over.
shall flow.
Over the offering. Amen. Father, we thank you. It is always a pleasure and an opportunity to bring our substance in your presence. We pray, oh God, that as we have been obedient, may every word concerning offering and tithe be made manifest in our lives, especially in our finances. For every hand that gave, may you multiply and expand their financial territory. And for every hand that was not able to give, oh God, grant them opportunities, divine opportunities, and open doors unto them, that next time we meet, they will be able to give to your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. We have another video, amen, that the media team would be Oh, thank you, praise and worship. Amen. That the media team is going to play for us, and after that, we would invite our dancers, Redemptive Life dancers. So let us listen to the video. Amen.
Anniversary VSC. Hi, my name is Farah from Victory Faith Chapel. I first joined the ministry back in 2011. I was about to turn 18 years old when I met Apostle Seth. Oh, okay. So we're from West Palm, so that's where we encountered him first. And we were affiliated with, my mother is also a minister, so we were affiliated with Prophet Kirvin at the time. And my, you know, we would always go to his church in Fort Lauderdale. And Apostle Seth was actually ministering at Prophet Kirvin's church. And my mom had saw him, and he was passing out flyers for his own services at the time. And so my mom came home. She's like, oh, I met this wonderful prophet. He's African. We're going to go visit his church. My first impression was very interesting because we didn't know he was the pastor. We didn't know he was the prophet. So when we first encountered him, he was in a church building he was renting out, actually. And it was like a vacant, like church, like, you know, you rent out a church for service, it's kind of vacant or whatever. And we couldn't find it. And it was crazy. But when we walked in, he was just like, hello, welcome. Please take a seat. And so we walk inside and we're taking a seat. And then the same guy goes up and he's like at the keyboard. And he said, we're going to start worship. And he just starts singing. And we're waiting for this, for the prophet my mom was talking about. We're waiting for him to come out. So we could, you know, hear the word of God and everything. And then the same guy on the piano starts to preach. So I'm like, oh, is this the so we're all looking at each other, is this him? And then after that, that's when he starts prophesying, and it was powerful. And I'm like, wow, he did all of this. And I was like, I didn't know this was the pastor. So that was my first encounter with Apostle Seth. That was very, very cool. But he was just so humble and just so kind-hearted and so soft-spoken. And he was just like, thank you for coming. And, you know, so nice and cordial. And it was just like, wow, I was like, God, like, my first impression, I prayed for him actually that day. Like, when I first saw him ministering at that time, I instantly prayed for him. And I remember looking at my mom and I was like, Mom, this pastor, he has to make it. This isn't him. He has to make it. He has to be great because he's too humble, he's too sweet, he's too amazing. Like, he did all of this himself. He has to be great. He has to be great. And I remember just sitting there and praying for him and saying, like, God, please make a way for him. Make a way for him, please, Lord. And I remember looking at my mom, like, Mom, he's gonna be great. My mom was like, yeah, he's gonna be great. And now look at us 10 years later, like, 3 branches, like, huge. I'm sorry, I'm about to go on a whole tangent. Next question. That night, yes. So that first night that we went to his service, he prophesied to me about two things that came to pass. He prophesied that I was going to get a vehicle. At the time, I wasn't driving yet, and I wasn't looking for any cars or anything, because I was just about to graduate high school. But he did prophesy to me that I was going to be, I was gonna have a white car. And that car I was gonna use to do ministry with, that I was gonna help out and do ministry with it and everything like that. And the following birthday, my following birthday, which was my 18th birthday, my brother's actually surprised me with a white BMW. And so, and I was like, oh wow, like, the prophet said that I was gonna get a white car, and I did for my birthday. And then he also prophesied about my schooling. He's the only prophet that ever spoke to me about my education. And he told me that basically that I will never have to pay for anything out of pocket regarding education, that God pretty much has set my path regarding my education, that I was going to graduate with 3 degrees, and I'm on my way to get my master's, and I have no debt at all. I haven't paid anything out of pocket for school. So yeah, most people would have been paying out of pocket by now. I haven't paid a dime. So yeah, so everything that he said up until then has come to pass. He gave me, honestly, I always say this, Pastor said this is the reason why I have a voice. I have a podcast now, and it's only because of him, because he's the one that called my voice out. I was behind the scenes doing everything in the church, running around, just doing stuff behind the scenes, never really talking on the pulpit, but he called me out to do the women's conference twice. And the first year he called me out to do the women's conference, I thought he was joking. I thought he was joking at first, and I was like, okay, yeah, and I walked away, and he's like, oh no, Sonia is gonna come take your picture for the flyer. And I'm like, oh, you serious? Like, for real? And he's like, yeah, you're gonna do the women's conference. And so he called me, he prepped me, he helped me break the word down so that I can teach it well, because I had the vision, I had the idea of what I wanted to teach on, but he was there like how he is, though. He's a teacher, so he really sat there and taught me how to read the word, break down the word, and to make it relatable to everyone. And he worked with me for a few weeks, and I went up, and I mean, I was even surprised at how the Lord was speaking through me, and how I was up there talking. Like, it was like an outer body experience, because I was up there and I'm just talking, and I'm just like, Pharaoh, this is you? Like, wow. And so the fact that he saw it in me and called it out of me, which is why I trust his vision so much, is because he can see a thing. And so when he sees it, and you got to trust his vision, like, he sees it, I believe it 100%. If it wasn't for Victory Faith Chapel, if it wasn't for the ministry of Apostle Seth, I wouldn't be this person right now. When I think of VSC, what comes to mind is perseverance. That is the word I was looking for, perseverance. Because throughout every season, we faced some type of obstacle, like some type of major obstacle comes our way, or even minor obstacle that comes our way. We push through no matter what. Jesus is my dog, okay? He's my best friend. That's my confidant. I love him so much. He's my everything. I don't really have I don't have a father in my life. And my encounter with Jesus, see, I was raised in church, right? So, but I never accepted Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior growing up. I always thought when I die, on my deathbed, that's when I'm gonna say, okay, Jesus, like, take me now, you know? But my first encounter with him was because of his sacrifice. I learned more about his sacrifice for us, and I realized it was for me. And when I realized that he died for me, he became everything for me in that moment. And I really gave my life to Christ. I want to say when I was 17 years old, that's when I really gave him my everything. And in that moment, I realized, I'm like, God, I really don't have anyone but you. And so he became my first love in that moment. I've never felt real love outside of Jesus. Like, that love, I can't compare to any love in my life. And so he's my first love. He's my best friend. He's everything that I have. I have nothing. I was literally saying that on the way here, like, crying in the car. I'm like, I got makeup on. I got to do a video today. But I'm like, God, I love you so much. Jesus, I love you so much. Because when I think about it all, and I look back, and I know it's so cliche when we think about the goodness of the Lord, but really when you think about everything that he's done, even the minor things that he pays attention to for us, it's amazing. So I'm not going to cry, dog. You see how you do me? I love him.
Oh, out of my belly shall flow river, rivers of living water. Out of my belly shall flow. One more time. Out of my belly shall flow rivers of living water. Yeah. Somebody pray in the Holy Ghost right now. Somebody pray in the Holy Ghost and begin to stand. That river, stand on river, aya. Eh, anana maya nene bele di da bala de de bea. One more time, pray, pray it out. Nations are inside of you. Answers are coming from your inside. Aya, aya, aya. We sing it all together. Out of my belly,
out of my belly. Shows.
Any painter can paint, but only CertaPro painters come with power. The power of dialing up the...
Out of my belly shall flow rivers, rivers of living waters. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
as the river flows, it begins to bring every death into life. It's a life-giving river. Oh, let it flow right here, right now. And as the river flows, it begins to bring every death into life. It's a life-giving river. Oh, let it flow right here, right now. And as the river flows, it begins to bring every death into life. It's a life-giving river.
Bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. That was so beautiful. As the river flows, may you receive the power to be able to go to the next level in your life. As the anointing flows in this house, may everything that seems to be dead be revived in your life. Hallelujah, hallelujah. It is a time that we have all been waiting for. Can you stand with me? Amen. We are about to hear from the man of the hour, the man with the vision, our papa, our daddy, the apostle, the prophet, with a shout and a clap. Let us invite Prophet Seth Amuabwaten. Amen.
Praise the Lord. There will be a heavy downpour of fresh fire today. A heavy downpour of fresh fire today. a heavy downpour of fresh anointing today. A heavy downpour of fresh fire today. There will be a heavy downpour of fresh favor today. A heavy downpour of fresh favor. Is that simple? There will be a heavy downpour of fresh fire today. You respond. A heavy downpour of fresh favor today. You get it? There will be a heavy downpour of fresh fire today. Of fresh fire. You got it. There will be a heavy downpour of fresh fire today.
There will be a heavy downpour of fresh anointing today.
A heavy anointing
of fresh anointing today.
There will be a heavy downpour of fresh favor today.
A heavy downpour of fresh favor today.
There will be a heavy downpour of fresh healing today.
A heavy downpour of fresh healing today.
Oh, there will be a heavy downpour of fresh anointing today.
A heavy downpour of fresh anointing today.
There will be a heavy downpour of fresh grace today.
A heavy downpour of fresh grace today.
There will be a heavy downpour of fresh fire today.
A heavy downpour of fresh fire today.
Ah, there will be a heavy downpour of fresh grace today.
There will be a heavy downpour of fresh grace today.
Can you give a shout of praise? Oh, some of you are not shouting. You are. Can you celebrate the Lord with a shout? Can you celebrate Jesus with a shout? There will be a heavy downpour of fresh fire today.
A heavy downpour of fresh fire today.
Pour down your spirit upon us tonight, Lord. Let your glory be revealed. Let thy kingdom come, and let thy will be done, O God. Touch us and make such a great impression in our spirit. Impact us to leave a legacy on the planet Earth before we exit out of this place. Give us an anointing that will impact our generation. Pour it on us. A heavy downpour of fresh fire today. Heavy downpour of fresh fire today. A heavy downpour of fresh fire. There will be a heavy. your grace. I want to say, Lord, let your grace fall.
Lord, let your grace
say,
fall.
Father, let your grace fall.
Father, let your grace fall.
The grace that makes men great.
The grace that makes
let that grace come upon me.
Let that grace come upon
the grace that makes men great.
The grace that makes
let
grace.
That grace come upon me.
Let that grace come
in
upon
the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I declare
in Jesus'
name,
Jesus,
I am not leaving this place
the same
as I came.
As I came.
There will be a heavy downpour of fresh fire today. Hey, a heavy downpour of fresh fire. Fresh fire today, a heavy downpour, a heavy downpour, atalalabotakata, a fresh fire today, a heavy downpour, a heavy downpour. Fresh fire today. Thank you, Jesus. I am speaking on a theme I've entitled Living Beyond the Grave. Living Beyond the Grave. You have not been called to live. Please give me a little volume in my microphone. You have not been called to live for yourself. You have been called to live for the people God have called you to live for. You have been called, that's right. Now fill the oil. You have been called to touch your generation. Your generation should be happy that you were born. You should never be a disappointment to the generation you were called in. There is a specific assignment and a purpose, and in fulfilling that assignment, when you are dead and gone, your voice will still echo in the corridors of the earth. This year, the Lord inspired us to theme this year the year of legacy. Maybe some of you think we have to give a theme. But I'm telling you, there are deposits that is going to happen this year in your life that is going to influence you, cause you to do things that after you are dead and gone, those things shall remain. Our Lord and Savior Jesus died 2,000 years ago, and up till now, we still sing songs about him. We still write books about him. We still write poems about him. He never built any building, any church building, but he built people. And he left something in those people. And what he left in them, they also didn't die with it. They left it in other people. And the thing has passed, it has been passed from one generation to the next generation. And I came to tell you that when God is speaking to you, he's not speaking to you. When God is speaking to you, he is not speaking to you. He is speaking to your loins. He's speaking to your children. He's speaking to your children's children. He's speaking to the generation coming after you. And so God is not a God that only thinks about the now, but he is a God of legacy. Now, whatever he has done, we still talk about it.
when he was with Elijah, the things that Elijah did, we still call on the God of Elijah. When God was with Moses, the things he did with Moses, we still talking about it. Everything that God did with any individual didn't die in the grave. It lived beyond the grave. There are many people that have died and we don't remember them. We don't remember them. There are others we still celebrate them today. They are living beyond the grave. God has given me a vision. And I'm going to share this vision throughout this entire anniversary celebration. And you, when God birthed a vision in you, he brings the provision. And he brings the people that will have the wisdom, the strength, the capacity to help the vision come to pass. He releases angels, divine assistants, to make sure that the vision is what? It's fulfilled. Wow. Tonight, God is going to touch his people. God is going to touch his people. I sense a strange anointing that just came here. Let me tell you something. The Lord placed something in my heart many years ago, but I feel like I have to release it this year. So West Palm Beach is a very difficult ground for ministry. There are a lot of young people that have great potential and anointings, but I'm messed up with drugs, alcohol, and all sort of things. A lot of young people, very, very gifted and anointed, but have no future. Listen, so the Lord inspired us to build a legacy center. And this legacy center, you see, man is a tripartite human being made of the body, soul, and spirit. Body, soul, and what? Spirit. Please sit down. Sorry. Body, soul, and spirit. I feel fire all over me. I feel it. Man is made of what? The body, the soul, and the spirit. And so the whole idea of this legacy center is to take care of the psychological needs of the people, the spiritual needs of the people, and the physical needs of the people. Are you here with me? I know there are other ministries that are, and every ministry is doing their part within the kingdom to impact lives. So when God puts a vision in your heart, just follow the blueprint that the Lord has given you. Are we here? Amen. And so, by this vision, we are going to build a rehabilitation center, and it's going to take care of those that just came out of the prisons. One of the assignments of Jesus in the book of Isaiah is to set the captives free. Now, people can come out of prison, but the prison is still in them. Like the children of Israel came out of Egypt, but Egypt was still in them. It's still there. So they are out of prison, but they still have prison mentality. That's where we come in. To help them reprogram their lives and give meaning to their lives. And we are, by the grace of God, I mean, I won't go beyond myself, ahead of myself, sorry. God is connecting us with certain people that very soon we will be able to have the accreditation to give these people that will go through the training with us after 3 to 6 months a certificate that will help them get jobs. Because you see, when people come out of prison, it's very difficult for them to get jobs. But because of the connection and the training we are going to take them through, it's going to be kind of a trust thing that anyone who goes to the Legacy Rehab Center has been worldwide deprogrammed and reprogrammed to benefit the society. A lot of these people that don't have hope, I'm telling you. When they come out, It's like there is no sense and reason to live anymore. And God wants us to create an environment that will give them hope. Secondly, there are some statistics which I'm going to bring tomorrow and Friday of people that are addicted in Florida. When you talk about drug addiction, it's not that they want to. It's a situation. And I know that there are a lot of other rehabs that they take them to, and sometimes they stay there for 3 months, 1 month, right? Or 3 months to go. There's a special program we are going to develop. I mean, some of them are spiritual, some of them are psychological. So we will have doctors psychiatrists that will be there to help when it comes to the physical stuff. But we also have pastors, and we believe in God that through the training center, we are going to do the prophetic training, right? To be able to identify things that are spiritually inclined and believe God for the authority to deal with it if it's spiritual. And so I want to show you a video to, can you turn the light off so you can get a picture? I mean, we were able to develop something to give you a picture of what we want to do. But it is not full yet. But I want you to have a taste of that video. Please, media team, if you have it, let it roll.
Happy 10th year anniversary, VFC.
Start it, please. Start it. Start it. This is Future VFC. Garden. Hallelujah. Oh, can you celebrate Jesus? Can you celebrate Jesus? Are you excited at all? Hallelujah. The Bible said, write the vision make it plain, and they will run with it. You are believing God that in the next 2 years we will be here. Oh, you don't believe it. You don't believe it. I said in the next 2 years we will be there. It can even be before that. If you, anyone believing God with me, just lift up your voice and say, Father, I believe that all things are possible. And it's not done. Trust me. When by next week, the full picture is going to be, it's so beautiful. Hallelujah. We couldn't get everything on time for the anniversary. But I hope we have seen where God is taking us. Oh, your amen is so. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to deal with something spiritual. Deal with something spiritual, because some of us, before we can ever leave a legacy, there are some altars that needs to come down. There are some inscriptions in the spirit that you will never build anything in life. So no matter how much you work hard, you feel this resistance, you end up spending all your money and not building nothing. But a yoke is going to be destroyed. Tomorrow, Prophet Diallo is going to be here. Oh, you are not excited. You see your life? My spiritual father is going to be here. He had some interesting revelations he'll be sharing with us that I can't wait to hear. I told him, share with me. He said, no, when I come, I'll share it with your people. Hallelujah. And Friday, we're going to have Dr. Cindy Trim with us. Oh, is that all you can do to celebrate our mom? Then Saturday is the legacy concert. If you have not purchased your ticket, make sure you purchase it now. Amen? Hallelujah. All right. Joshua chapter 4, verse 20 to 24 is our main scripture. Let's read it. Joshua chapter 4, verse 20 to 24. You know, after Joshua and the people have conquered and they were crossing over, they said, God have done marvelously well with us. He has opened the Jordan River. He has done great stuff. And we cannot go to the other side without letting our children know what God did for us. And so they did something. Before I continue, I hope most of us have seen one of the best and anointed gospel artists in the world here with us. Amen. He's waiting. Tomorrow he's going to fire. Amen. And so tomorrow is going to be fireworks here. Emmanuel Smith is in the house. Let's celebrate him. Amen. Tomorrow is going to be fireworks here. Tomorrow is going to be powerful. How many of you were blessed by the prophetess? Beautiful. Hallelujah. And our Redemptive Life dance group. Powerful. Where are they? Hallelujah. I need to pray for them. Amen. Praise God. Clap for yourself that you were able to make it tonight. Give me the next 45 minutes and I'll be out of your way. Is that okay? Oh, is that okay? If you are happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you are happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you are happy and you know it and you really want to show. If you are happy and you wave at me. You see, some of you don't listen to instructions. Say wave at me, you are clapping. Cut you. If you are happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you are happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you are happy and you know it, and you really want to show. If you are happy and you know, keep silent. Wonderful. That means you hear the voice of God. There was this guy that they were going to have one of the most toughest exams. And this teacher, a lot of people fail his exams because his exams is very, very difficult. So he told the class, this exam is going to be the most difficult exams you have ever written from me. Hey! I mean, the previous exams that we couldn't pass, and you are telling us this is going to be the most. But those that know how to obey instructions will pass. So they went to the exams hall, and the questions were like 500 questions to answer. And they had only 1 hour. And they're like, this teacher is wicked. And before the exams, they said, read through every instruction before you start the exams. Now, you have 1 hour to answer 500 questions. So some have no time to read the instructions. They started number one, number two, and they were answering because you have to do everything. So 2-3 minutes, one person got up and presented his forms. He said, I'm done with the exams. So people were like, what? How can you finish all these exams within 2 minutes, 500 questions? After 5 minutes, another person gets up. I'm done. After 4 minutes, another person gets up. So this guy was just writing, answering. And he was wondering why people are just getting up. So 10 people were able to finish their questions under 10 minutes. And they left. And the rest were there. After an hour, the teacher said, stop work. And some of them had only answered 80 questions. Some of them had only answered. So now the teacher was going to go through the questions with them. And the instructions is, don't answer any question. The instruction is, don't answer any question. Turn in your paper and leave. That was the instruction. But those who refuse to follow instructions, the teacher said, make sure you read every instruction before you start the exams. And they were like, no, I've studied. They started answering because they were told they have 1 hour. But those who read the instructions realized that they don't have to answer the question. That is how sometimes life is so simple if you only listen to the voice of the Lord. That some of us going through complicated issues which are the most simplest thing. But it's complicated because you are not hearing God's voice. You are not following his word. I'm praying that you will begin to hear the voice of God after this conference. Amen. And you will have the spirit to obey. You must have an instructed heart. I'm telling you, this new generation, if you don't have an instructed heart, you miss out on the spirit of God. An instructed heart is a heart that is willing, ready and willing to do whatever God says they should do. Does that make sense? Like, God already knows you are a willing person. That's why he was able to boast about Job. Have you considered my servant Job? Oh, Satan said, do you think he serves you for nothing? God knew the kind of heart Job had. He knew that he would never betray him or turn his back on him in the face of adversity. So you can do your worst, Satan, but don't touch his soul. I pray that you will have a certain heart. If God says, sit here, don't go nowhere for 10 years. You'll be able to do it. Because there will be many reasons to move. But your father says, sit, don't go nowhere. Snakes will come, don't move. Scorpions will pass, don't move. You will hear the roar of lions, don't move. That is the instruction. You see, when God gives an instruction, it doesn't look smart sometimes. It takes divine wisdom to obey. We are going to look at an instruction God gives someone in the Bible and how his obedience brought deliverance to his family. Joshua chapter 4, verse 20 to 24. It says, and those 12 stones which they took out of Jordan, did Joshua pitch in Gilgal? And he spake unto the children of Israel, saying, when your children shall ask their fathers in time to come, that means that they are going to do something in the present that they have to report it in the future. In time to come. Where is it? Saying, when your children shall ask their fathers in time to come, saying, when, what meanest these stones? What are these stones for? Why have they piled stones here? Then ye let your children know, saying, Israel came over this Jordan on dry ground. What it means is that there was a miracle that happened here where God had to open the Jordan River for us to walk on dry ground. This miracle, we should not forget. It will make our children know the God of our fathers. It will let our children know the kind of God we serve. If there is no memorial, our children shall be born and they will forget and they will serve other gods. That is why I'm so bent on this vision on the legacy, how do you call it, project, that we will have a center for the youth and the children's ministry and pour so much into them, because the kind of children we are having and the young youth we are having in this generation, I'm telling you, 15 years to come, we will lose most of them. So if you are just thinking about now, you will die and go, and the person who will inherit you is a foolish person. Like the book of Ecclesiastes said, he said, I have tasted pleasure and I have amassed wealth for myself. Anything my heart desired to do, I did. So what my eyes saw and my heart desired, I went for it. Solomon said, I was able to receive and get whatever I wanted as long as I desired it. But after I realized all this is vanity, it is meaningless, because the faith of such a person is the same faith of someone who had nothing. For all shall return to the grave. And he said, after getting all this wealth and after getting all this money and projects that you do, you will die and you don't know whether he who will succeed you will be wise or will be foolish. That's what the wise man said. So if we are not intentional with legacy, we will work in vain, because the children that will come after us will not be wise in the Lord, and they will not know the reason why we did what we did to continue, and they will destroy and mess up everything that we built. So the Lord has laid on my heart, you don't want to be gray-headed before you choose who will succeed you. You have to start looking now. Jesus never built a building. He built people. His focus was on people. It is not what you live for people, but what you live in them. Are you here with me? It is not what you live for people, but what you live in them. Jesus built, he carefully chose 12 people. Then out of the 12, he chose 3. There was one particular one among them called Peter that he consistently was praying for, because he had to invest in Peter and leave Peter his church. Jesus focused on Peter and left Peter his church. Elijah focused on Elisha and left Elisha his mantle. David focused on Solomon and left Solomon his crown. Who are you focusing on? And what will you leave that person? There's certain, and some of you will leave them with generational curses and debt. That is why I'm here for you. Because all you inherited from your father is trouble and problem and spiritual harassment. There was no one that rose up in your family that broke curses, that stopped the mouth of beasts from devouring the men and women in the family.
But God said that there is a girl, there is a boy that I'm raising from this family that I will use to stop the mouth of lions, and I will use to bring down giants, and I will use him to break curses, spells, so that the generations yet unborn can have a reason to live for tomorrow. People, focus on people. I believe when we begin to think like that, and God inspires you to watch one particular person, and you can use 20 years to invest in the person. You can use 10 years to invest in the person. 30 years. I'm speaking not to you. I'm speaking to your future. If you live for now, you'll be very miserable. How did you feel when you saw the future of the church? How did you feel when you watched the video? You felt hopeful. You felt like we are going somewhere. You felt energy. You felt that is how you must see. And anyone who don't see with you, you can't live with the person. Leave it for the person. Are you here? And sometimes, how will you know that this is the person that should inherit, or I should spend my years pouring in? It will be very disastrous if you spend 10 years, 20 years pouring in one person and that person never leave your legacy. One of the tragedies of life. That is why you cannot use 2 years to determine who must succeed you. Legacy is all about the successor. Who is going to take over from you? That's what legacy is about. I know most of you don't. You are quiet because you've never thought like that. You are just living your life and you're only thinking about your children. Which of your children? And sometimes it's not even about any of your children, but it could be someone else. Because God's mind is very different. God is more purposeful. And so if you live an emotional driven life, you will miss destiny. But if you live a purpose-driven life, nothing moves you. If you live a legacy-driven life, nothing moves you. Am I in church at all? Ask your neighbor, who are you focused on? I'm telling you, you can be 25 years and God can show you your Joshua. You can be 30 years and God will show you your Elisha. And I'm telling you, these people will have a special passion for you. Nothing you do hurts them. Have you forgotten Elijah? Elijah was so mean to Elisha, but Elisha was not moved by the attitude of Elijah. He said, what do you want from me? Praise God. What do you want from me? Elijah didn't say, why are you talking like to me like that? He said, stop following me. What do you want from me? Elijah was never offended. He said, sir, I need a double of what you have. I need it. I'm so focused on the mantle that your character don't move me. Those are the people that can succeed you. God, I'm speaking into the future. I'm speaking into the future. I'm speaking into people's future. I'm speaking into people who can handle every aspect of your life and still hold on to you. Who believes in your vision? Who is ready to die for your vision? That is your successor. That's your successor. You must find out. Parents, not all your children want what you have. There is one among them that is proud of what daddy is doing. That is so proud of what mommy is doing. And said, mommy, I'm done with my doctorate, but I believe in your vision. I'm going to use my expertise to push this thing. Those are the people you leave the legacy for. Because when you leave the legacy for them, they will keep the legacy. Imagine the apostles messed up. We will not be here. Christianity would have been dead and gone. But even the apostles, they kept it. They fought. So Paul said, I have fought the good fight of faith. I have finished my course and I've run the race. I have fought. He fought what was handed down to him. And he also passed it to his generation. And the sad thing is, as the generation deteriorates, the force of the legacy weakens. But if you train them well, they can also impact and it can only increase. Have you noticed the wealthiest people in the world are families? Wealthy, it's not individual, families. The Saudi king, family, 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 family. Listen, listen, listen. I have come to understand something spiritually. That, let me say this. If you want to be wealthy, I've said it before, I'll say it again. And if you want to be rich, find out who succeeded in your family and what kind of job the person was doing and do the same job. You won't understand the wisdom in this statement. You can be rich, but not wealthy. You can have an all right money to take care of yourself. But after you are dead and gone, that's it. It ends. But there is it Rockefeller family? Is he still alive? He's dead and gone. But his legacy and his name and his wealth is still here. You can mention their names. It's a family thing. Trump family. His grandchildren will come and enjoy Trump Towers. We need to leave something for our families. That after we are gone beyond the grave, we will still be living. Our monument will still be speaking. Our books will still be speaking. Our tapes, our CDs, our songs will still be sung. Martin Luther King and John Wesley and their brother, they wrote songs. And now we are singing them as hymns. They are dead many, many years ago. But we still celebrate. They are still living beyond the grave. There is a battle you must conquer if you want to live beyond the grave. I feel something in my spirit that most of you are at the back of the door. All the family members are at the back of the door. Who shall break this door open? Who shall break this door open? Who? Who shall break this door? Media team, change this thing, okay? Who shall break this door open? Judges chapter 6. Verse 12 to 25. Didi, can you read for me?
Judges chapter 6, reading from verse 12. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor.
He said what?
The Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor.
And look, oh, mama, please hear me. We are about to pray. He said, the Lord is with thee, you mighty man of valor. Let's look at who the Lord, the angel called a mighty man of valor. Continue.
Verse 13. And Gideon said unto him,
Oh,
my Lord.
He said, look, you are calling me a mighty man of valor. Now, Gideon is about to reveal himself. He said, oh, my Lord.
If the Lord be with us.
If the Lord be with us.
Why then is all this befalling us?
Why are we going through all these troubles? How many of you have gone through troubles and you wonder if God is with me? Did God call me? Oh, did you take it off? I said, change it. Praise God. God, if God is with us, all these things will not happen. This kind of statement, who have ever made it before in your life?
Yes.
And sometimes when you begin to go through so much trouble, the people around you will even ask, where is your God? Are you truly a believer? Maybe there is a curse on your life. Maybe you've done something wrong. That's why God is allowing all this trouble to come. If God is with us, why am I suffering? Why am I struggling? That's what Gideon was saying. Continue.
And where be all his miracles which and
where,
our fathers...
Where is the miracles that our fathers told us? So you see why legacy is important. They left the stones at the Jordan so the stones will remember them of what their fathers did. And so Joshua said, when your children ask, where from these stones? Tell them that the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob help us cross this Jordan River on dry ground. What? And when the day we cross this river, we put this stone here. For the stone to be a memorial. Amen. For the stone to be what? A memorial. That will remind you of how great your God is. The stones will remind you of how powerful your God is. The stone will remind you how miraculous and how strange your God is. That he performed strange acts that no other God has ever done. So your faith and your trust in this God will increase and will heighten. But when there is no testimony of a miracle, how can we remember that God? How can we pray to that God? After we don't even know. We won't even remember because our fathers died and never told us of their God. Like most of you, you come to church and leave your children home. You are hurting their future. You are serving God. And you are allowing in the name of, I love my children. He said, train up the child the way. There is a way the child must go. Yes. You are the one to train the child. Amen. Discipline them if they need discipline. Because it's biblical. One thing is this generation don't like discipline. And it will keep weakening until you cannot even say anything to your children anymore. You can't. Because we Christians have allowed it. Do you know that still... our Muslim brothers and sisters, they still hold on to their values. No. You cannot be a Muslim and be doing this. But Christians, that is why the world don't respect us. Because we easily give in to their demands. We will even fight other Christians down into trying to help us. No discipline. No fortitude, no endurance, nothing. We can't endure. Then how can we leave a legacy? So he said, thou mighty man of what?
Valor.
Continue.
And where be all his miracles which our fathers told
where
us of?
Where is the miracles that our fathers told us?
Saying, did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt? But now the Lord hath forsaken us. And delivered us into the hand of the Midianites. Verse 14. And the Lord looked upon him and said, go in this thy might.
Look at that. It's like God has even ignored what he said. He said, there is a might in you. You are complaining about how the Midianites are exacting on you. You are complaining. But you don't know there is a power in you. Go in that power. You are complaining that God, when? Why? God said that the reason why he's delaying is because you are not using the power that I gave you. Go in this thy might. And he's not, he doesn't look like someone who have any might. There is something in you that you don't know is the answer to your prayer. There is something you carry that because of the circumstance going on around you, you have taken your eyes off the might that is within you. And God sent me as an angel to declare that go in this thy might. There is a power in you. Stop complaining and stir the pool. Stir the pool. Stir that pool within you and go within that might. Continue quickly.
Go in this thy might and thou shalt save Israel.
And thou shalt save Israel. You are there complaining about your family. Meanwhile, you are the one they are waiting for you to save. I'm complaining, why are we going through this? This is my family. I have to move out of this state. I don't want to even be with them anymore. Meanwhile, you are the answer to their prayer. You are the answer. Turn to your neighbor and say, you are the answer to their prayers. Continue.
Go in this thy might, and thou shalt save Israel from the hand of the Midianites.
After tonight, you are leaving, and you are going to save
Amen.
Your family
Amen.
From that long-term problem.
Amen.
You are going to receive a grace and an anointing that will save and permanently deliver your family.
Amen.
Deliver your community.
Amen.
This community will be delivered. As long as VFC is here, this community shall be delivered. You see, I know those that will take the legacy. They believe in the vision. Continue.
Go in this thy might, and thou shalt save Israel from the hand of the Midianites. Have not I sent thee?
Have I not sent you?
Verse 15. And he said unto him, O my Lord, wherewith shall I save Israel?
He said, how can I save Israel? Like, God, are you telling me to? How can I save Israel?
Behold, my family is poor in Manasseh.
Now, look at the way he's describing himself. He said, my family is poor in Manasseh.
And I am the least in my father's house.
So, that family is so poor. Is the poorest family. And in his family, he's also the least in that family. Do you understand? His family is what? Poor in Manasseh. So when it comes to families, his family is the poorest of all the families. Manasseh maybe is the least of all the tribes. Then his family is the least in the family. And in his family, he's also the least in the family. So the poor calls him poor. I don't think your situation is hopeless like Gideon. The person you are looking for help from needs more help than you. But God was not talking to them, Gideon. He saw a man that carried oil that would deliver an entire nation. A man that carries the spirit of legacy. And that man has taken out of the battle of life. And he's saying that my family is the least of all the families. And I'm the least in the family. So if there is anyone to use, not me. And that is how some of you feel. And God was not talking to that self-pity person. He was calling the giant in him. He was calling the hero in him. He was calling the king in him. And I came to wake the sleeping giant up.
Amen.
I said, I came to wake the sleeping giant up. The giant that are sleeping.
God said, I should come and sound the trumpet. Wake up!
Wake up!
Wake up! And go in your might. Read.
Verse 16. And the Lord said unto him, surely I will be with thee.
Ah.
And thou shalt smite the Midianites as one man.
Uh-huh.
17. And he said unto him, if now I have found grace in thy sight,
uh-huh,
then show me a sign that thou talkest with me.
Uh-huh.
Depart not thence, I pray thee, until I come unto thee and bring forth my present and set it before thee.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, I will tarry until thou come again. Mm-hmm. Verse 19. And Gideon went in and made ready a kid and unleavened cakes of the ephah of flour. Mm-hmm. The flesh he put in a basket, mm-hmm, and he put the broth in a pot,
mm-hmm,
and brought it out unto him under the oak, mm-hmm, and presented it.
Mm-hmm.
And the angel of God said unto him, take the flesh and the unleavened cakes, mm-hmm, and lay them upon this rock,
mm-hmm,
and pour out the broth.
Mm-hmm.
And he did so.
There is a way to provoke God's presence and prophetic activities. Did you see the instructions? I don't know if you would have done it. You say it's too much. That's why we are not seeing miracles, because we want to do it our way, how we feel it is. So once the instructions make us a little uncomfortable, we will say it's not from God. So Gideon was doing all these things for God to demonstrate something. Keep reading.
Verse 21. Then the angel of the Lord put forth the end of the staff that was in his hand and touched the flesh and the unleavened cakes.
Mm-hmm.
And there arose fire out of the rock and consumed the flesh and the unleavened cake.
Do you see that? Sacrifice. And fire came and consumed it from nowhere. And that was the proof that God was with him. And sometimes it is your sacrifice that will provoke God's action in your life. You cannot prove God just by testing him. You have to prove God by provoking him with a sacrifice. Now, God, this is what I'm going to do. If you don't come through, I will die. This is all I have. I'm giving it. If you don't come through, I'm finished. This, you are committing him. But if you are like hey God, you know, like God kind of thing, no. He's not a child. He wants people who mean business. He said, Abraham, go and kill your first and only child. The only child you have been waiting for 100 years. Go and kill him. You know, Abraham had an instructed and a willing heart. God was just testing him. Instructed and a willing heart. And he was willing to do it. And he never told the wife. What it means is that anything that can stop him from doing what he has to do, he will not even inform. But some of you, you go and call, mommy, you know your mom don't like church people anyway. You know, the prophet said I should do this, and you know, what do you think? What? Forget about him. Okay, it's a confirmation. You yourself, you don't want to do it anyway. Your heart doesn't want to do it, so you want people who will support your rebellious heart. That's what many people do in the church. The thing is, you don't want to do it. Or you want to do it. So you are going to talk to people who will support you. You see, it is not support. It's what God said. When 100 people support you, because there are many carnal people in this world. Many people hate Christianity. So if you are going to... I know when I go to Prophet Barber, he will tell me to do it. So I won't even go to him. I'll go to Teddy. Teddy. You know, and Teddy will say, you know what? I don't think you got to do it. I mean, if you don't have it, you don't have to.
You ain't got it.
Sweet, nice. So yes, that's exactly what I was thinking. Yeah, you don't have to. Go to Prophet Barber. Papa, you know. Professor, you know what? You have to obey God. you have to be obedient to God. You know, if God says it, he's going to do it. You got to be obedient.
Got to be obedient to God. Why are they laughing? You have to be obedient. And that is not what you want to hear. So, okay. And you respect him, so you just nod your head. I've got a second opinion. All right, read it. Let's finish it. Because I need us to pray and deal with it. Read it. Continue.
Verse 21. Then the angel of the Lord put forth the end of the staff that was in his hand and touched the flesh and the unleavened cakes. Mm-hmm. And there arose out fire out of the rock and consumed the flesh and unleavened cakes. Mm-hmm. Then the angel of the Lord departed out of his sight. Mm-hmm. Verse 22. And when Gideon perceived that he was an angel of the Lord, Gideon said, "Alas, O Lord God, for because I have seen an angel of the Lord face to face." And the Lord said unto him,
"You will see an angel face to face."
Amen.
Oh, whoever will shout the loudest amen, you shall receive it. I said you shall receive an angelic encounter this week. The louder your amen, the quicker the manifestation. You shall see an angel this week, face to face. Continue.
Verse 23, and the Lord said unto him, "Peace be unto thee.
Peace be unto thee.
Fear not.
Fear not.
Thou shalt not die." Mm-hmm. Then Gideon built an altar there unto the Lord.
And Gideon did what?
Built an altar.
You have
there
to learn how to build altars. Some of you, God do something for you and you don't even thank God. You know, one of the traditions we do in Africa is this. For example, God gives you a child, right? You're believing God for a child. God gives you a child. You're coming to give a testimony in church. You come with an envelope and come and thank God. That's what a testimony is. Thank God and now share your testimony. If God, you were struggling to pass your exams and you passed your exams after you encountered God and you are coming to give a testimony, come with an offering. You don't. What you are doing is you are building an altar to make the testimony permanent. So some of you wonder why you gave a testimony and you lost the testimony. What altar did you build after the miracle happened? Amen. You have to learn how to do that. It provokes. Okay, continue.
Then Gideon built an altar there unto the Lord and called it Jehovah Shalom. Mm-hmm. Unto this day, it is yet in Oprah.
Someone say legacy. That altar became a legacy until this day. Sometimes your prayer is the legacy. Continue.
Unto this day, it is yet in Oprah of the Abizrite. Verse 25. And it came to pass the same night that the Lord said unto him, "Take thy father's young bullock unto the second bullock of 7 years old, and throw down the altar of Baal that thy father hath, and cut down the grove that is by it, and build an altar unto the Lord thy God upon the top of this rock in the ordered place, and take the second bullock and offer a burnt sacrifice with the wood of the grove which thou shalt cut down." 27. Then Gideon took 10 men of his servants and did as the Lord said unto him.
And did what?
As the Lord said unto him.
Tell your neighbor, you got to learn how to do as the Lord says. Continue.
And when...
Have you seen sacrifices? If your life is not full of sacrifices, there are certain curses you can never break. And sacrifice is not only giving money. It's not only giving money. Sometimes your commitment to God's service. Commitment. Even in pain, you are in it. When God begins to bless some people here, don't be jealous because you don't know what they've done for the Lord. Don't know. Have no idea the pain, the shame they have been through because of the gospel. They have lost good people just because they chose to choose sides with God. Certain people have hazarded themselves. So when God starts blessing them, you might think it's now. People that have spent sleepless nights just to pray. Sometimes with this anniversary that we are doing, some people, they are working, they are doing this, they are doing this. Sometimes they only sleep for 2 hours and get... You think that sacrifice, God will look at it in vain? You are building a certain legacy. There are times that I'll be preaching through sickness. I will never forget the prophetic conference. I will never forget. After preaching, I go into sickness. The moment I stand on the stage, you remember, right? You were here. Was home with me. I was so sick. Extremely sick. I don't think if it were you, you would come to church. You would call me and say, Pastor, I'm not feeling well. I will not come. So what about Pastor who is sick? And I'm coming to scream. Look at the screaming and the jumping that I did after. Right after, I go back. The moment I hand, I'm like, God, why are you doing this to me? When I come here, the anointing comes and I don't feel the thing. Even, I remember the first day when I started speaking, I was hoarse, I couldn't even talk. Then something came on me and I started singing as if I was never hoarse. But the moment I'm done and I hand over the mic, and I sit there, I see that I start feeling feverish. And I had to go home. I'll take this and I'll be weak. I'll sleep throughout the whole day, coming to church tired. And I come and preach, do deliverance. You saw what the power of God that day. Do all this deliverance. It's because of you God give me the anointing. Yeah. The anointing is not for me. You see, whatever gift you have is not for you. That is why you will pay the price when you die and go to the grave with your books. Jesus. If you go to the grave with songs you were supposed to write, you never wrote. Because of laziness, because you hurt someone, because you are not. God will judge you. There are books in you that is supposed to be written. You are sleeping. You are lazy. You are coward. There are sermons you must preach because of cowardness. And what others will say, you are not. I'm so touched with our sister. She started doing live videos, right? Yeah, she was very shy. Very, very shy. But now God's anointing has come. She's preaching on the street and doing all that. When I see it, I get so proud and excited. Yeah, you sit down and wait till you are perfect to do everything. You are waiting to have a platform or to be perfect or to have everything. No. The legacy. Read it quickly. Jesus.
And Gideon took 10 men of his servant and did as the Lord had said unto him. Mm. And so it was because he feared his father's household and the men of the city, that he could not do it by day, that he did it by night. Mm-hmm. 28. And when the men of the city arose early in the morning, behold, the altar of Baal was cast down, and the grove was cut down that was by it. Mm-hmm. And the second bullock was offered upon the altar
that
was built.
You see, the altar of Baal was broken. What altar must break in your family tonight?
Amen.
Something, an altar that has been fighting you, must be broken tonight. Amen. Continue.
Verse 29. And they said one to another, who had done this thing? Mm-hmm. And when they inquired and asked, they said, Gideon, the son of Joash, mm-hmm. had done this thing. Mm-hmm. Then the men of the city said unto Joash, bring out thy son, that he may die, because he had cast down the altar of Baal, mm-hmm. and because he has cut down the grove that was by it. Mm-hmm. And Joash said unto all that stood against him, will ye plead for Baal? Will ye save him? He that will plead for him, let him be put to death whilst it is yet morning. If he be a god, let him plead for himself.
Now, read a verse 25. You will see that Gideon defeated all of them. Read a 25.
Verse 25. You mean the chapter?
The verse 25.
Okay. And it came to pass the same night that the Lord said unto him, take thy father's young bullock, mm-hmm. even the second bullock of 7 years mm-hmm. old, and throw down the altar of Baal.
And throw down the altar. That instruction. You see, God is saying you are a mighty man of valor. You are what? A mighty man of valor. For you to fulfill and conquer the people I've told you to go and conquer, the first thing you must do is to do what? Throw the altar of Baal. Destroy the altar in your father's house. That is the spirit that is controlling the life of the people.
that is not allowing the miraculous hand of God to move. If you want, the reason why your family is the least and you are the least is because of this altar. Throw it down. And that is the assignment we are going to do. That legacy can only happen when certain altars have been destroyed. The things God has called you to do, you are a nation mover and a community transformer. But because of an altar, it has caused you to stand at the back of the gate.
Jesus.
We are about to pray.
Amen.
One of the greatest legacies Jesus left the disciples was to teach them how to pray. Teach them how to pray. The disciples observed the life of Jesus and they saw that his life was full of miracles, signs and wonders. And they observe, how come this man, how is he able to do all these? And they started studying the patterns of his life. Let me ask, what is your life patterns? Do you know that you really don't have a set any pattern that will take you to your next level? All the patterns of your life is bringing you down. You wake up, you sleep, you watch movie, you sleep. That kind of life, after 10 years, what will become of you? But if there is a particular pattern, you sleep, you wake up, you watch movie, you eat, you go to work, come home, sleep, watch movie, this, that. That, what kind of legacy can such a person leave? Because after 10 years, your mindset will be screwed by the movies you are watching. After 10 years, you will not have any passion for the destiny you have been called to. You will be having passion for things because the eye is the gate into your soul. And your soul is the seat of your intellect, your will, and your intelligence. So the kind of intelligence you need to drive your destiny, you will have intelligence for movies.
Oh, Jesus.
Meanwhile, you are not called to be a movie star. You can argue and mention all the names of the movie stars. It won't put food on your table. It won't live in. And so you realize, you see, there are people that watch the news. And there are people that make the news. May you not be the one watching the news, but may you be the one that is making the news. I release that grace and anointing upon your life. You will not be sitting on the television watching people making legacy and changing things, but you'll be the one people will be watching. Can I make a statement to you? I'm telling you, those making the news don't have time watching television. I came to announce to you, it is time to change your daily habits. I said it is time to change the pattern of your life. If you want to change your life, you must change your mindset, and changing your mindset will influence your desires. And when your desires are impacted, you will make the right decisions that is in alignment with your destiny. Change your life patterns. You can look at somebody's life and you know this person is going somewhere. Per the activities of the... This person is always reading a book. This person is always asking relevant questions. Not unnecessary questions. Relevant questions. One of the things that my soul detests is unnecessary questions. I don't know. Those of you who are with me, you know. When you ask me an unnecessary question, it's just... Because I found out that your ability to ask the right questions will take you very far in life. You have to ask yourself the right question. Asking the right questions in life brings the right solutions. There are some questions that don't have answers. It's not relevant. You see, your whole desires and your mind and your psyche must communicate to your destiny.
Amen.
But the kind of communication your destiny is receiving is not moving because that is not the language it understands. Amen. Let me say it again. Your destiny wants to move and it's not moving because your mind is communicating something different. It's speaking a language, destiny. Jeff, bruh. Oh, why? (Laughter)
Jeff, where? You see, I'm speaking. I understand what I'm saying, but that is not the language he understands. I'm speaking in my native language. You don't understand what I'm saying, so you'll be there. Will you move? I'll tell you.
Jesus!
Jeff, budget 3 million. Remember 3 million, watch it. Do you understand what I'm saying? Did they tell her what I said? So now I'm telling you I'm going to give you 3 million. You are still sitting there. Because the language is not your destiny language, you are missing blessings. Oh my goodness. If you will begin to position yourself right, watch the right movies, read the right books that are inclined and in line with your destiny vibration. That is in line with your destiny vibration. You'll find out that everything you do communicates to your destiny. That is where you get to a place where you have drive and passion in life. So sometimes you are wondering, why this brother has so much passion? He's speaking his destiny language. What he's involved with is speaking his destiny language. So it drives him. You don't know why we pray the way we pray. Because prayer is our destiny language. You don't know what I'm talking about. It's our destiny language. When we pray, something comes upon us. We receive divine infusion for where we are going. So the disciples observed the life of Jesus. And they said, we want to know the secret of his miracles. We want to know the secret of the outcomes of his life. And they observe him wake up early in the morning. When they wake up, where is the master? Then one of the disciples will say, he is hiding in the woods praying. And they observe this thing for a particular time. When I observe your life, what pattern will I see? They saw a pattern of prayer and they concluded this is the secret for the miracles happening in his life. And so they said, Jesus, we need to ask you a question. And they summoned Jesus for a meeting and they said, Jesus, teach us how to pray. We don't need you to teach us how to open the eyes of the blind. We don't need you to teach us how to raise cripples. We don't need you to teach us how to cleanse the lepers. When we learn how to pray, we will receive what you receive. We will be able to take onto our hands the mantle you carry, because you received what you received because you were praying. And then Jesus said, you have asked the right question. I will teach you how to pray. When you pray, begin to acknowledge that God is your father and is not a god. He's a god of all flesh, but he's father to the sons. So say our father, don't say our god, because God reigns on both the righteous and the unrighteous. He doesn't give inheritance to servants. He gave the inheritance to sons. And so the Bible said, beloved, now are ye sons. We are sons because we are the one qualified to receive the inheritance. What is the inheritance? The inheritance is the legacy. I can only receive the legacy when I'm a true son and I'm a true daughter of Yahweh. And so he said, when you pray, address him as a father. Don't pray to a god like the other gods. The hidden pray. The hidden pray to their gods. But you don't pray to God, a god. You pray to your father. He respond to you as a father. He doesn't respond to you as a god. He responds to you as a father. And so your father doesn't look at your sins to respond to you. He responds according to your needs. Antemehatata, a god will respond to you based on what you have done, right or wrong. But a father shall respond to you because you are his loin. You came out of his loin. You are part of him. You carry his DNA. That is why he will listen to you. I pray, Kadima Sotaya. I feel the hand of the father. I feel the hand of Elohim in this place. Bring her, let me touch her. Bring her quickly. Under the anointing, quickly, quickly. Okay. Put her down. Put her down.
Listen to me. Teach us how to pray. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. And Jesus taught them how to pray. And because they were taught how to pray, he said, I'm going to leave something in them. He never built a church. He never built mansions, but he built a people. My assignment is to build a people. And you know what? If you are building something, build something that will build people. That is why the legacy project is something that will build people. It is not something that we are just building because it's beautiful. We are building it's a training center. After we are dead and gone, we will live beyond the grave. Jesus said, I will teach you how to pray. I will teach you how to pray. When you lay hold of prayer, when I'm not there, you can deal with the adversary. You can deal with the enemy. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. For the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. As I change into the realm of prayer, Matakutaya, I receive something that no money cannot give me. And I don't need your money. Teach me how to pray. I don't need your connections. Teach me how to pray. When I lay hold of the spirit of prayer, I can bring down giants. I am Moshe. David said, why are my enemies increasing? He said, why are many raising against me? Why are many turning against me? He said, I have many troubles, but I give myself to prayer. I give myself to prayer. I will not only pray, but I give myself to it. Church, VLC, as your father, what I put in you is the spirit of prayer. I might not have money to give you, but I have prayer to impact into your spirit. I might not have the world for you, but as I've taught you how to pray, if you continue, I see the prayer mantle coming on 12 people here. Let the prayer mantle Lord, touch them. Release those 12 people. Bring them to me here. I die. Pomi atantuma. Apenimios. Pam pamu yahadea. Apeya tumata. I see fresh fire. I see fresh fire. I see fresh fire. Atelekatela. Telekatela. Let there be an impartation. Hey! Lift up your hands. Something is happening. There is a stirring. There is an impartation. Akatole heke. Zeketele wahata. Leketele zihatos. Begin to pray in tongues for the next 3 minutes. As loud as you can. Something is about to enter you. It can never be taken away from you. Come on, be aggressive. Teach us how to pray. Prayer is our legacy. Epe pelua. Epe pelua hata. Come on, cry out. Does it. Akatia. Ape. Power.
katalabekatua, repete katepe, repete zutea, peshanada, rakata tibiriyatata, repete katalibiriyapa, raskota biribiriyapa, peshanada baya. The fire of Jehovah, the fire, is being imparted. Receive the prayer mantle. Receive the prayer mantle. Receive the prayer mantle. It's coming. Ha! Ekatele wahatanda. Ekatele zika. Patura katera tera. Bash! 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 Bash, 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 Jesus, Jesus, oh, ah, 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 ah. Yes! 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 Uta! He does! Ah! He boss! I guess! He pa! He does! I best! He lost! I pa! Ipaya, Utaya, Itaya, Ipas, Ipas, Ah, Itos, Itas, 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 Upa, Atas, Kopos, Ah, Ipa, Ipa, Itos, Itas, Apas, Ikas, Apas, Ayo, Apas, Ayo, Apas, Ato, Apas, Ato, Apas, Ato, Ipas, Ato, Atas, Ato, 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 Who passed? Jesus,
Jesus. Lift your hand. There is a heavy downpour of fresh fire today. A heavy downpour. Lift your hands. Oh, fresh fire today. Lift your hands. There is a heavy downpour of fresh fire today. Heavy downpour. Lift your hand. Oh, fresh fire today. There is a heavy downpour of God's grace today. A heavy downpour of fresh grace. Ah, look at the anointing. There is a heavy downpour of fresh anointing today. Oh yeah. A heavy downpour of fresh anointing. Listen. I don't know. I didn't know what this is, what God wants to do. But God says he's placing mantles in the hands of some 14 people. It's the mantle of the prayer and the prophetic. Lift your hands. Those 14 people, ushers, please observe. Because some of them will see lights. The fire, the fire, the fire of prayer, the fire of the prophetic is coming upon them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Fire! Yes. Fire! A fresh fire! Wherever the 14 people are, lift your hands, everybody. The Holy Ghost is going to locate them, bringing them from the back, from the far right. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, release the mantle of prayer, the mantle of prophetic. Wherever they are, let them catch it, let them catch it. Bring them to the front, bring them to the front. Aha, aha, hot fresh fire today. Coming, yes, prophetess, it's on you. Increase. It's heavy here. There is a heavy downpour of fresh fire today. Lift your hand, everybody. Heavy downpour. Receive the anointing. Receive the mantle root. It's coming on you. Take it. Take it. Oh. Fresh fire today. The spirit of prophecy is in the house. Lift your hand. The spirit of prayer is in the house. In other words, the spirit of Elijah is in the house. It's coming. Yes. That's it. That's it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Some will begin to prophesy. Some will begin to speak in an unknown tongue. People are entering the angelic realm right now. Ha 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 ha. For I hear the Lord say, it's time for people to experience the angelic realm. Mm-hmm. It is starting. It is starting here right now. Take it, yes. Nah, take it, take it, take it. There is a fire that will come on you, you can never recover from. This is something that will remain on you permanently. Call her for me. Come. You need an impartation. Come here. Quickly, stand here. Lift your hand, everybody. Holy Ghost. Power, Holy Ghost. It's in her. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. It's on her. 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 From today, this impartation shall remain. The fire. The fire. The fire. Take yours. Lift your hand. Lift your hand. Another level. Rivers of living waters. Lift up your hands. I say rivers of living waters. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. I see it coming. I say rivers of living waters. Hey, lift your hands. The anointing is coming. It's coming. I say rivers of living waters. Akatole kata tata. Akosha kata. Ekata kata. Rivers of living waters. Living waters. Yes, yes, rivers, rivers of living waters. Osekola bahata ya, osekola bahata, osekola bahata, okotolo bahata, eketele berehota, sokatios, bimnio baba sonda, rekadonda, venamenokosa, peperewosa. Rivers of living waters. Yeah, yeah. There is a glory here. There is a glory. Hey, rivers. Living waters, of living waters, of living waters, of living waters, living waters, yeah, yeah. Lift up your voice, hey! Ay, ay, ay. Ah, yeah, ay, 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 ha, ay. Yeah, yeah.
pack it. You came here to receive. Pack it. Take it. Lift your hand. Your prophetic unction has been stirred. Take it. Another level. Oko kozoko bahari yada. Listen. Those that are thirsty shall be filled. My dear, the Lord loves you. The Lord's hand is upon you. Oh, you shall do more. Zon no more komo. Look at the sweet presence of God. Omo mo simo mane ko mama. Kopa mama mama mama. This girl is about to enter the angelic realm. Angelic realm. They will see angels physical. Angels will speak to you. She's about to get into a deep realm. Look at that. Look at that. I see three angels dancing around her. She can feel their presence. Songo. You see, she's entering that realm. She's entering that realm. Cover her. Okoma sakatana makomo sanama. Jesus. So call paper katon popori pemponi mi katon kapari bidioto popon topozom pibidiopa prekete katuri bidia katesopo fede ketomene kato katakati bidibidibidibidiosa There is a new generation rising up. There is a new generation rising up. There is a new generation rising up in power. There is a new generation rising up. There is a new generation rising up. There is a new generation. Enter the realm, it's yours. In power. There is a last day army. There is a last day army rising up. There is a last day army rising up. There is a last day army rising up to war. There is a new generation. There is a new generation rising up. There is a new generation. Rising up, there is a new generation. Rising up in power. There is a last day army. It's the last day army. Rising up, there is a last day army. Rising up, there is a last day army. Rising up to war. Release the fire. 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 Lift up your hands. Yeah, release the fire. Release the fire.
Release the fire.
Declare it. Release the fire. Something will happen here. Release the fire. Release the fire.
Release the fire.
Release the fire.
Release the fire.
Release the fire.
Release the fire.
Release the fire. Release the fire. Come on. Release
the fire.
Hippie. Hata. Velos. Release the fire. Zuma, Zuma, Hita, Hites, Hipa, Ata, Hites, Hitos, Pamos, Hita, Pomes, Ah. I believe that when we ask, you send the fire. I believe that when we ask, you send the fire. Aha. I believe that when we ask, you send the fire. I believe that you send revival. Send revival. I believe that when we ask, you send revival. Send revival. Send revival. Ay, 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 ay. Send revival. Shada da da ha. Send revival. Send revival. Homa. Send the fire. Send the fire. Send the fire.
Send the fire.
Send the fire. Receive your mantle. I said, receive your mantle. Receive your mantle. Lift your hand. Let this place be very quiet for the next 1 minute. We are about to close. Close your eyes, everyone. The spirit of legacy. Some of you, Satan, have said you will never leave a property. Never own one. It's a lie. You will never do anything meaningful with your life. It's a lie. There is a spirit of legacy coming on you that will break all the altars in your father's house. I want you to hold the hand of a neighbor standing by you. This is our last prayer. Hold the person's hand tight, even if the person is falling. Hold that person so tight. Your prayer is, we are about to enter your father's house. This is the most important prayer we are praying in this evening. God says the things he has called you to accomplish, there's an altar in your father's house that must come down. If it doesn't come down,
it will be hard. Within the next 3 minutes, I want you to pray with all the energy in you. And what you are saying is, I release fire. Let the fire burn utterly and destroy any altar in my father's house. Go into your father's house. You carry your father's DNA. You break yourself free from the negative patterns of your father's house. And you declare that any altar, any spirit that controlled and manipulated the life of the men and the women in your father's lineage, break the altar, destroy, burn with fire. When I shout one, you say fire. Two, you shout fire. Three, then you start praying. One,
fire!
Two,
fire!
Three, begin to pray. We'll send the fire to your father's house. Any altar, please concentrate. If you don't see it, it doesn't happen. Fire it. You have 2 more minutes. Release every prayer in you. Pray as if tonight is the last night you are praying. Lift your voice.
Floridians, are you ready for this? Something historic and uplifting is about to go down at West Palm Beach. It's the West Palm Beach Legacy Concert 2023. Ministering live, Grammy Award nominee Chandler Moore of Maverick City. Grammy Award nominee and GMA Dove Award winner Jekyllyn Kopp. Award-winning gospel recording artist Joe Metal, Ghana, West Africa.
Alone is worthy of our praise.
The Voice UK semi-finalist Emmanuel Smith, London, United Kingdom. Victory Worship, and many more. It's happening at Sunset Cove Amphitheater, 20405 Amphitheater Circle, Boca Raton, Florida, 33498. Saturday, March 25th, 2023 at 5 p.m. Doors open at 3 p.m. Come experience it for yourself. An intense multicultural worship experience. You can't miss this one. Your 2023 needs this. Quickly get your tickets at Eventbrite. Search West Palm Beach Legacy Concert 2023. Floridians, are you ready?